This is the MLA essay format with Mr. Taylor. I have a Google Doc open here to show you exactly what I'm talking about as I go. So when you're preparing your document, you're going to start with the header. So you will type first your name. So here's the name of one of my students whose name happens to be student. And then you will, under that, type your instructor's name. Your instructor might have a particular way that they would like for you to list their name. For me, just list my name first and last name. And then under that, you're going to put the name of the course. If there's a particular course number associated with your course, this is where that would go to. For my class, we'll just type English Language Arts, and then you're going to type the date. And there's something a little bit funny about the way you type the date for MLA citations, at least for us Americans, because it's more fitting with the European style. And actually, it makes more sense because it goes from the smaller increments. So if the paper is due on the 20th, so the 20th of March, then you would type 20 March and then the year 2014. And then go down another line, and then this is where you will type your title. And when you have your title, you're going to center it. So you can click this button right up here in Google Docs. And then you'll come back down to your next line, and we're heading back over to the left side so you can left justify it once again. And then for your first line of your essay, make sure you hit the tab key so that it will be indented for the first line of every paragraph. Now, when you start typing paragraphs, make sure, for example, I'll type a nonsense paragraph here. When you go down to your next line, it should also be indented for that paragraph, and make sure that you don't put an extra space in between the paragraphs. So our header is all typed in. Of course, for your title, you would want to create an original title that fits your piece, but we do need to make sure that we change the font. I'm going to go ahead and click Control A. If you're on a Mac, you can click Command A, which is actually what I just did. And then you're going to choose, MLA says to choose a legible font, but almost every teacher will ask for Times New Roman, which happens to be right here at the top of my list. And it does need to be a 12-point font. And then from there, you also need to make sure that you have this double spaced. So mine is hidden over, I believe, in the more column. If I click this little line spacing option, it will allow me to make it double spaced. Just to clarify, double spaced does not mean two spaces between every word. It just means that there's going to be this extra blank space between the lines of your text. There will be one more thing that I want to add to my document to make sure that I'm ready for the MLA format, and that is going to be the page number. Now, I'm typing in Google Docs, and as of what I've looked around into, it does not allow me to put the page number on every page except for the first page, which is what some instructors will ask for. But we're going to go ahead and add the page number to every page. So we can go up to the top and hit insert, and we'll come down to page number, and we want it to be at the top of the page. It'll be at the top right hand corner, and notice it puts the little one there for me already. And if I go down to the next page, notice how handy that is. It's already going to turn it into a two. The only thing that's missing is you want to put your last name in front of it, and of course this also needs to be Times New Roman and 12 point. All right, I would be ready to start typing my essay, and hopefully whatever you end up typing will make a lot more sense than all of this. And of course, make sure you have this indentation at the beginning of each of your paragraphs. And like I said before, don't put those extra lines in between the different paragraphs. Just when you're ready to start the next line, it'll be indented and it'll start on the next level right below that. So this is how to format your papers with MLA citations. And I am Mr. Taylor. I hope you have enjoyed the video, and I hope you find it helpful. Thanks.